So we're right now we're just glad to win.
You're 7-0, but given how sloppy off and on and sporadic things happen today, what are your priorities and your concerns as you try to get ready to play Wisconsin next week?
Well, you know, we always talk about winning the games, but we also immediately when we do that, we have to go back and examine what it really looked like. We've got, I really like this team a lot, but we're not very pretty often enough. So we're just going to try to get better, Jerry. That's our deal. We got to go back and work. These kids are pretty realistic. They'll see it, and we'll go back to work and do everything we can to get ready to beat Wisconsin.
Hey, Coach, thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jerry, and thank you, Coach.
Undefeated and not pretty is okay.
It's still undefeated, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, it is.
Well, don't forget, tonight at 8 Eastern, ABC Saturday Night Football has number 2 Ohio State at Penn State for Ed Cunningham and Dr. Jerry Punch and our entire ESPN ABC crew. This is Mike Patrick saying so long from Lincoln, Nebraska. Thanks for watching, everyone. It's all yours.
Well, wait, let's just get started and we'll see what happens. Which one you want to do first? Post game analysis? Yeah.
Plus, if you could hum a few bars. Say it again, please. It's I've already lost interest.
So I'll lead you to the highlights. I'll lead you to the package, Jeff.
Have cash in there. It's very picky.
Tick, tick, tick. If I left right now, I might make it. Me? Mike's Mike.
There you go. What's your airline?
Southwest. You check that for me, see if it's delayed to Denver?
It's never delayed to Denver. Really? Okay, we're done. It's funny. Is this like the catcher taking one in the cup? If it's somebody else's flight, it's funny.
Yeah.
If it's yours, it's not funny at all. We know how it feels. All the circumstances for this game would say Purdue didn't have a chance. They fired their coach last Sunday. They come in, they're playing the number 8 team in the country in Lincoln, and yet they gave it just a tremendous performance, had the lead for a while.
And just a horrible start for interim head coach Jared Parker decides to call a trick play on their first offensive play. It's a halfback pass intercepted. Tommy Armstrong walks in for a touchdown on the next play, 7-0 in 16 seconds. But Purdue came to play, and they have a quarterback in David Blau who can really throw it. He's number 1 in the Big Ten in yards per game. An excellent play fake early finds D'Angelo Yancey, who ended up with 2 touchdowns, including this 88-yard score. Last year, Yancey had an 83-yarder in a win over Nebraska. So 2 big games for Yancey 2 years in a row. But It came down to what may end up being the winningest quarterback in the history of Nebraska, and that's a mouthful when you say that, with Tommy Armstrong, who looks finally healthy. He's a guy who's been battling a little bit of an ankle injury, and when he steps into his throws, and that's a big win because sometimes he doesn't, he really does have a nice arm. And for Nebraska, everyone's going to be asking, is this a top 10 team? I still don't know.
Well, we've asked the last 2 weeks, how good are they? Because they have struggled at times, even though they have won. But we will find out in the next 2 weeks. When you have to play Wisconsin and Ohio State, at the end of that period, you're going to know how good you are.
But keep this in mind. Even if Nebraska loses both of those games, they could still win the West Division.
Absolutely.
Because Wisconsin already has two losses. So if they were to lose again and Nebraska wins out, Nebraska could be in. So even if they go 0-2, this Nebraska team may be hanging around until November.
All we still have are questions. Pretty soon we'll get the answers.
Sure. After an interception started the game, the very first offensive play is Tommy Armstrong on a zone read walking in from 22 yards away, a game that felt like early on it may be a blowout. But David Blau played terrifically at quarterback there, finding D'Angelo Yancey for a one-yard touchdown, then multiplying that by 88 yards when Yancey goes 88 for the touchdown there. Two scores. And shockingly, Purdue was up at halftime. But Pearsonell, DeMorney Pearsonell catches a quick slant from Tommy Armstrong. Again, a nicely thrown by Armstrong. Nicely thrown ball by Armstrong. And then Moore gets good blocking downfield, scoots down the sideline, and Nebraska pulls away at the end. Hold on 1 second. All right, ready when you are. And I'm coming out and going to the right, Anthony, when I get down. Yep.
Or tell Zip to put it online.
Yep.
Hey Zip, put
a little
it floop,
a little flippy. That works. Let's roll.
Zoom in.
Well then, come on. I really would like to go, so let's just do it. Got it. There you go. The camera just moved, by the way. There it is. It's moving. The big question this week and the week before was, is Nebraska a top 10 team? I still don't know the answer to that, but I do know that they're undefeated and have not played well at all. So for the next 2 weeks at Wisconsin, at Ohio State, what if Nebraska plays better? By admission of their own coach, they've been sloppy. They should have Jordan Westerkamp, their best receiver, back. If that happens, I wouldn't count these guys out. They're really alive in the Big Ten West, even if they lose the next 2 weeks.
way to win the game. That's it. That's what we came to do. Let's go. Hip hip!
Hooray!
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 Okay, take a knee and grab somebody. All right, here we go. Be thankful. Be thankful. Grab somebody. How about those Huskers? Okay. Now listen. It's a dangerous
night.
Dangerous night. Be careful. Be careful.
All right.
And one thing I want you to do. We know how that game was. It was hard. It was back and forth. They made some plays. They came here to play. They came here to play, and they competed. Give them credit for that. And at the same time, what do we have to do? We got to get better, right? We got to go. We got to go. We got to make that realistic. But as a team right now, enjoy that win. Appreciate that win. Celebrate that win with your teammates. That's good. You should be happy. We won the game. Okay, we'll fix the rest of it. You got me?
Yes,
celebrate. This was good. We just went to 7-0. That's good.
Yeah.
Well, okay. Yeah. Have fun with it.
No, don't. Us.
Remember, with that celebration, it is also a dangerous
night.
We want everybody available. I want no phone calls in the morning. All right. Sam Cotton, bring it in.
Post game here with Coach Riley, followed with
hey, Sam.
Players after that.
All right, this will sound like a little bit of a broken record. We are extremely happy to win the game. We thought that my feelings are Purdue came here and played hard, and their intentions were to win. I think their quarterback's a real good player. He made plays. So did their team. We struggled in a lot of ways, and we kind of just had to stay with it. I thought that we did, after the first quarter, settle down defensively. We gave up big plays and didn't look very good in the first quarter. But we became more consistent defensively as the game went on. Offensively, it was hit or miss all day, and not enough consistency, but enough plays to score and win the game. That's it.
What's the level of concern about the offensive line right now, and how touch and go was it with Nick playing today?
It was probably a decision that was talked about as late as this morning, you know, and we're pretty thin there right now, but we're not going to talk about that too much, because we expect, you know, when we go out there, we expect to look better than that and play better than that as a group. Have some more consistency, and I'm hoping that we will feel better and get healthier as we go. You know, we'll have to look at it closely. Neville has now started and come out of, what is that, 2-3 games in a row, something like that, 2-3. But so we got to look at all that pretty hard. Sam, I think that it really hurts what has been kind of the formula, the recipe for this team when we gain 1 yard or none on first down. You know, we were doing so well third down conversions just as late as a couple of weeks ago. And as we all know, that's a great stat, but it's also a product of doing pretty good on first and 10. And if you can gain 5 or 6 yards on first down, it changes the opportunity a lot more to be a better third down team. Therefore, it just looks better. We were always just struggling today, it felt like to me. I do appreciate how we do struggle and how we then do eventually have enough in us to make some plays to win the game. And it's just kind of glimpses to me of how good we could be if we could just kind of find a little more consistency, I think, in the running game primarily, because we can do the rest of it. We just have to be better. And we have been disrupted there a little bit, obviously, through the injuries to that group. But I think everybody has that from time to time.
How well did your wide receivers play today? Stanley made a play. Riley made a couple. DeMorey had the touchdown. Sam Cotton, not a receiver, but a tight end. How well did that group of guys play today without Seaton and Weston?
Yeah, I think that this is really a good group. When you talk about our receiving core and you include all those guys, Sam, I think that that's appropriate. And I think that besides being a good group and people that can make plays, it is in that whole area of catching passes and making plays, it is our deepest area on the team probably. Because it would not normally be very easy to fill in for Jordan Westerkamp and Seaton Carter and make it look like football at all. But we have enough guys that can make plays that we can do that. I really like this group.
Mike, was your intent to run the ball more, especially the first half? And was it just a matter of you weren't getting much done?
Well, you know, yes, I think we did want to run the ball. I don't know about more. What it appears the best way to describe what we are right now is there's no rhythm. There is no rhythm to saying, okay, this is going to be a good thing on first down. This is how we'll accompany it. It just felt like it was like this. And things got a little bit better, obviously, as we went. And we hit some plays that were nice-looking plays. But those came late. There was no consistency early. There was nothing that we could say, okay, this is what we can rely on.
What do you think about special teams today? Caleb had a nice rugby punt with a block at the end, but also Trey Bryan with a big return. Just overall, how do you feel about that?
I think that we had a very nice day on special teams today. Like you said, we had the one great rugby punt that went down to the one. We had a nice kickoff return, and what in the world. We almost get that last punt block. That really bothers me. And we changed the protection. We sent one protection out. And then I think the kids went back to, what they had in the game plan earlier in the game. And we should have just stayed with it and punted it, and we'd have been fine. But I just hated seeing that. But overall, special teams was pretty good.
I know you concentrated on Purdue all week, but you got a big one now next week. What are your thoughts just about where your team is at as you head into a game like that in an atmosphere like that?
Oh, I think it'll be great for our team. It'll be great for our league. It'll be all those pieces that you get to when you play later in the year, when there's a little more definition about who the teams are that are kind of rising in that, we're heading into the third quarter area of the season. So, it's kind of one of those games in that part of the season that is, between two teams that have done well, and it'll be good.
How well did your defense play over the last three quarters?
I thought really well. We played smart because, Purdue is they're kind of who they are. They lead the Big Ten in passing yardage, and they're second to last in running yardage. And so we played better to their strengths as the game went on. We certainly didn't early. We give up a monster, 80, 90-yard pass play. And so you're playing right up their alley. The one thing you cannot do with a team like that is give up big plays, and there we start the game like that. And that's really, that play is what really caused everything to be like it was for so long, I feel. Because that just pumped them up totally, gave them some confidence. Had we been able to do more early, that we might have been wouldn't have had to maybe go through all that we did. But I'm still proud of our guys. I think we still play our best ball as the game goes on. And we did what we had to do to win in the second half, fourth quarter of the game, and that's great.
Anything else for Coach?
Okay. Thank you all. Have a good night.
Thanks, guys. Thanks so much. Good luck, man. Thanks, guys. Good to see you. Come on. Yeah. Thanks, bud. Here we go. How you doing, guys?
Good.
Chase,
thanks.
My guy's still got a tummy. Oh, kid. Yep, get her done, guys. Yeah. How you doing there, kid?
How are you?
Good.
Touchdown pass. Thank you. Last pass complete to number 8, Markell Jones. Hedrick Young on the tackle for Nebraska.
Thank you.
Johnson. Thank you.
previous ruin on the field. The previous play was a reception. Previous play is under further review.